Tim asked me if I'm familiar with Young Turks, and of course I have to answer like Cenk. Of course! Right? He says that a lot.
It's awesome.
Of course it's awesome. Yeah.
I feel like the series has progressed a lot, and both of Ice King and Finn have changed and gotten more complex and older.
And older.
Yeah, that happens, unfortunately.
Well, okay, technically we're all getting older, but I mean more mature.
People age. It happens. Get over it.
Yeah. The characters get more mature. I'm not sure about the actors.
Yeah.
I mean, the series, you know, started out as one thing, as much more straight ahead than it is. And then, you know, as the series got more popular and they, you know, more seasons, more episodes, more success, they've really, had the freedom to branch out and do different types of episodes. Yeah, yeah. Every episode has a different tone. Some of them are really serious. Some of them are really high adventure, you know, Tolkien type quest.
Some of them are super comedic and just like bro time, just hanging out doing nothing and
like
just
dopey
stupid
sitcoms.
Stuff.
Yeah, like the one where Finn just opens his pocket, Jake's there, he farts. That's the end of the episode.
Yeah.
But then there's other like Simon and Marcy. I was watching that and just tears running down my face. Like,
you know,
you too.
That
episode has brought a lot of people to tears. Like a woman here at Comic-Con, she just came up and started talking about that episode, and I realized as she was talking, her eyes were misting up, you know? And then like I was so touched that she was misting up that it's kind of like watching somebody yawn and you start yawning. I was like,
I know, it's so touching. The father-daughter relationship of
this doomed world and this little sick girl and this kind of ill-equipped guy trying to do the right thing. It sort of brought up all my anxieties about parenting.
Oh.
I'm a damn good parent, but I'm saying a lot of times, like, the world is so out of your control.
You can
control.
Be the best.
Narcissistic Tom comes back.
Basically, I am awesome. That's what I'm saying.
What did you say? He said, I am a pretty freaking great voice actor.
I'm a great voice actor, man. No, I was just agreeing with somebody that said it in order to seem like an egotistical jerk.
You're a great voice actor.
Well, yes, I am. Thanks for pointing that out. I knew it, but it's nice to have it validated by Kim.
What's it like singing on the show? I mean, you got the auto-tune on, though.
Which you don't need.
Yeah, that made me sound like a jerk. I just said, I don't need it. Like,
I'm so
unintentionally.
Good. I'm the best singer.
Narcissistic Jeremy.
Hey, you're a good singer.
Thank you, I appreciate it. It's fun. The thing about the little songs and stuff, they just like lay them on you last minute. You're like, I gotta sing now and stuff. So it's really fun though. I actually do like the auto-tune ones the best because they're so funny and it's just so computerized. It's great.
It's such a weirdly bad, but you actually, Jeremy actually is a really good singer that plays in a band that's really good and doesn't need auto-tune. You won't say it, so I have to. But I gotta say, like Jeremy was saying, like on the show, like a lot of the singing, you don't realize you're gonna be doing it until you walk in and they go, we got a song for you. Throw it at us and we'll do it.
Do it now.
Do it now. Oh, it's Kim on the Young Turks. They're not jerks. They've got their quirks, but they're not that young, but they're Turks. Kim is young. Sorry.
That's
wow.
Gonna be tuned in dubstep remix. It's going to be great.
That's going to be a promo for the Young Turks
totally
channel.
It is, just so you know.
So, part of the voice actor thing is that you are kind of like, it's really kind of boots on the ground. It's way more fun than being on camera, I got to tell you. Like,
it seems
right?
like it is.
It's the heat of the moment. Like, you just kind of roll with it and stuff.
But you're on camera a lot these days.
See, but I will say they are very, very, very different. So I don't, when people ask me, like, what do you like better? I usually don't give a clear answer because they're so different. You can't really compare them, in all honesty. It's like.
Yeah, but when you're sitting around waiting to do your three lines on some sitcom that you're guest starring on and nobody's talking to you and you're sitting at a table all by yourself, you're just going, I'd much rather be doing a cartoon. I could have done 25 cartoons by now. Let's move this along, people.
Do people recognize your voices from your roles, like when they're just meeting you on the street?
I've never had somebody be like, oh my gosh, that's Finn, you know?
You mean when you speak?
Yeah, I've even had people say like, are you Finn? I'm like, yeah, they're like, do the voice. And do the voice, they're like, you're not him. Okay.
Or even worse, they think you do a sort of okay impression of the guy that does the real character.
Yeah, all right, well, thanks for talking to us.
Cool, I look forward, when do we do part two of this interview?
Whenever you want. Let me give you a card, actually.
We'll be right back with more of Kim, Tom, and Jeremy.
Wait a second. Kim, get underneath Trudy.
No, man, please. I freaking hate Trudy.
Kim, I will destroy you.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, do it, Kim.